His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa was handed a written letter from the custodian of the two holy mosques and monarch of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, inviting His Majesty to attend the fourth summit for Arab and Southern American countries set to be held in Riyadh next month. His Majesty the King was presented the letter by Saudi Ambassador to Bahrain Dr. Abdullah Al Sheikh during a meeting at Sakhir Palace. The ambassador conveyed to His Majesty the greetings and appreciation of King Salman and his wishes for Bahrain and his people, further progress and prosperity. His Majesty the King expressed thanks and appreciation to the custodian of the two holy mosques for the kind invitation, expressed a pride in the existing deep-rooted historic relations between the two kingdoms and people, as well as in the deploying of brotherly cooperation and coordination in various fields. His Majesty also commended the pioneering and leading role of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, led by King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, in serving Arab and Islamic nations and defending just cases in the world. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace today Chairman of the Constitutional Court Sheikh Khalifa bin Rashid Al Khalifa, who introduced to His Majesty the King Judge Isa Mubarak Al Ka'bi, that performed the legal oath before His Majesty after the issuance of the royal order to appoint him member in the Constitutional Court. His Majesty the King congratulated Judge Al Ka'bi, wishing him success in performing his national duty. He commended the significant role of the Constitutional Court and its various bodies, highlighting its efforts in reinforcing the principles of justice, sovereignty of law, and respect to the constitutions. His Majesty confirmed Bahrain's keenness to support all authorities and institutions through national cadres that has proven its efficiency in all fields. He asserted that national process is continuous to achieve the best interests of the country and the people. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa patronized yesterday afternoon in the presence of BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa a celebration on the success of Bahrain Defense Forces officers' participation, Duty Force 1, within the Saudi-led Arab coalition to restore legitimacy in Yemen. On arrival, His Majesty the King was welcomed by Commander of the Royal Guard, His Highness Brigadier General Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and Commander of the Royal Special Forces, His Highness Major Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, who led Duty Force 1.
سلام سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة. سلام. قف.
الواجب الأولى سيدي. After the royal anthem was played, His Majesty the King inspected the guard of honor who lined up in his salute. Duty Force One has returned to the kingdom after completing its duty in Yemen as part of the Saudi-led Arab coalition. Duty Force One officers have courageously fought side by side with the National Yemeni Army and the public resistance supported by the Joint Arab Coalition forces in liberating the city of Ma'rib, regaining full control of Al-Mandeb Strait in support of Yemen's legitimacy so as to restore its progress and prosperity and deter foreign greed in the region.
جاءتكم بدء الطابور سيدي. قوة الواجب الأولى اليمين دور we
After that, the Royal Guard Commander Brigadier General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa delivered a speech in which he hailed His Majesty the King's directives regarding supporting the Saudi forces in securing its southern borders from the terrorist Houthi militias, as well as participating in the Arab coalition aiming at supporting legitimacy and maintaining stability in Yemen. His Highness added that following the directives of His Majesty the King to liberate the city of Ma'rib and Nabab al-Mandab, these special Royal Guard forces led by His Highness Major Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, as well as BDF units and with the support of Saudi and Emirati forces, the city was liberated in a record time. He also said that the Royal Guard forces are still participating in the Arab coalition operations in Yemen, in addition to the humanitarian assistance to the Yemeni people, in cooperation with the Royal Charity Organization, the RCO, and the Bahrain Red Crescent. His Highness hailed the bravery of Bahraini forces led by the Royal Guard Special Force Commander Major His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa in performing their duties and prayed Allah Almighty to rest the souls of the martyrdom in eternal peace and wished the injured a speedy recovery. His Highness expressed pride for His Majesty the King's patronization of the celebration and pledged to follow the directives of His Majesty the King and to defend the nation and its citizens. He then expressed his thanks and appreciation for all those who provided support while performing the honorable duty, and in particular to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and to the BDF Commander-in-Chief for their constant support. Then Captain Abdullah Ajman recited a poem on the occasion.
وسام الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة الدرجة الأولى تقديراً لسموه لما يقوم به من جهود مثمرة لتطوير الحرس الملكي وما وصل إليه من جاهزية قتالية ومستوى احترافي راقي وما اتسم به سموه من شجاعة وكفاءة عالية أثناء قيادته لقوة الواجب واحد إضافة إلى إشرافه شخصياً على حملة الإغاثة الإنسانية.
After that, His Majesty the King granted His Highness Sheikh Nasser the order of Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa First Class in appreciation for his ongoing efforts to develop the Royal Guard and for what he has achieved of high combat readiness and professionalism, as well as for his courage and efficiency in leading Duty Force One, in addition to his personal supervision of the humanitarian relief campaign that Bahrain is presenting to Yemen to lift its people's suffering, as well as for his numerous contributions in serving the kingdom. And in appreciation for His Highness Sheikh Khalid's courageous actions while leading Duty Force One and other forces from brotherly countries on the time of the attack on Ma'rib, His Majesty the King granted His Highness Sheikh Khalid the Order of Bravery for his courage and wisdom in controlling the situation amid rough times and minimizing human losses as possible. His Majesty the King also granted orders to the officers, non-commissioned officers, and individuals taking part in the noble mission in appreciation for their efforts during the honorable duty. His Majesty the King expressed thanks and pride in the officers of Duty Force One for their courage and efficiency, congratulating them on performing their honorable duty. He commended their heroic work and sacrifices, which are a source of pride for the people of Bahrain and brotherly militaries taking part in the operations. He praised the efforts of the officers and affiliates of the Royal Guard for performing their honorable duty side by side with BDF officers, wishing the kingdom's martyrs eternal peace. His Majesty wished success to all BDF officers who continued their duty as part of Operation Decisive Storm and Operation Restoring Hope within the Joint Arab Coalition Forces, wishing them safe return once completing their noble mission. The event was attended by senior officers and officials, as well as the British Parachute Regiment, who are taking part in special training with the BDF as part of the joint military cooperation between Bahrain and the United Kingdom.
Fabian Richard, Wissam Al Wajib Al Askari. الرائد الركن خالد بن علي آل خليفة، قائد كتيبة الحرس الملكي 12 وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن المجموعة المشاركة من كتيبته. الرائد الركن عمار علي القشار، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر القيادة المشتركة في صافر. الرائد الركن محمد جمعة الرميحي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر القوة المشاركة في عملية باب المندب. الرائد الشريف ناصر بن جميل، وسام الواجب العسكري. الرائد محمد عادل الذوادي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر اتصالات الحرس الملكي. النقيب خالد عبد العزيز العجمان، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر الأمن والحماية. النقيب عبد الله عبد العزيز العجمان، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر القوة الملحقة. النقيب أحمد خليفة الفضالة، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر قيادة السرية الأولى. النقيب محمد عبد الرحمن المريخي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر قيادة السرية الثانية. النقيب عبد الرحمن راشد النعيمي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر قوة الاحتياط من القوة الخاصة الملكية. ملازم أول خليفة أحمد الدوسري، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن المجموعة الأولى. ملازم أول أحمد مبارك الحمدان، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن المجموعة الثانية. ملازم أول عبد الله راشد النعيمي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن المجموعة الثالثة. ملازم أول ناصر راشد الرميحي، وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر الإسناد من القوة الخاصة الملكية. وكيل أول أحمد سليمان وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر وحدة التموين والنغل. وكيل أول عبد المؤمن حسن العمري وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر هندسة الميدان الملكية. وكيل أول خليل إبراهيم المطاوعة وسام الواجب العسكري، ويستلم بالإنابة عن عناصر الصيانة الفنية. أما الآن سيدي، يتشرف المصابين من قوة الواجب واحد بالسلام على جلالتكم واستلام وسام الواجب العسكري. وكيل محمد خميس غريب. وكيل علي صقر خليفة. رغيب أول فيصل عبدو عمر. رغيب أول نواف بخيت خليفة. رغيب أول أحمد يوسف الكعبي. رغيب باسم محمد صياد. رغيب صالح بدل صالح. رغيب محمد جاسم الغوتي. رغيب محمد عبيد إبراهيم. عريف فيصل ختلان دبح. عريف صالح جاسم المطوع. عريف ناصر عبد القيوم. عريف عمر صفوق فنطول. عريف محمد خاشع حارد. جندي أول يوسف يعقوب المهزأ. جندي أول شاب جاسم المسافر. جندي أول غازي علي محمد. وكيل حسين علي الدوادي ويستلم بالإنابة عن أخوه إبراهيم علي الدوادي. رغيب أول يوسف أحمد سعد ويستلم بالإنابة عن أخوه خالد أحمد سعد. عريف أحمد عبيد العنزي ويستلم بالإنابة عن ابن أخيه عبد الله سالم العنزي. جندي أول عبد الله إبراهيم الرئيس ويستلم بالإنابة عن أخوه أحمد إبراهيم الرئيس. جندي أول أحمد عبد الصمد حاجي ويستلم بالإنابة عن خاله محمود صالح محمد البلوشي. جندي أول عبد الرحمن الياس ويستلم بالإنابة عن أخوه عبد الله الياس.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa issued a circular regarding the official holiday on Ashura anniversary for the year 1437 Hijri. The circular stipulated that the kingdoms, ministries, directorates, authorities, and public institutions will take a two-day holiday on Ashura anniversary, which occurs this year on the weekend Friday and Saturday, and therefore shall be offset with another 2 days, Sunday and Monday, the 25th and 26th of October. His Royal Highness directed the early defrayal of October salaries and wages on Thursday, October 22nd, and the relevant bodies have been instructed to take the necessary actions for this purpose. BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa received at the General Command today Chairman of the Board of Directors of Al-Hikma Society and Chairman of the Supreme Council for Health, Lieutenant General Dr. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa. Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa welcomed the chairman and members of the board of directors of Al-Hikma Society, commending the efforts of the society in caring for retirees' affairs. The meeting also discussed several issues of common concern. Foreign Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa received today a group of activists in the field of peaceful coexistence from India currently visiting the Kingdom of Bahrain. The minister said Bahrain represents or presents a unique and worth emulating model of coexistence whereby all faiths, affiliations and sects live in harmony on the basis of solid value that are deeply rooted in the Bahraini community. He affirmed Bahrain's support to all the efforts aimed at reinforcing the concept of peaceful coexistence and cooperation as the dynamo factor behind stability, security, achievements, awakening of the peoples and their ability to surpass challenges. For their part, the Indian delegation members lauded the prevailing peaceful coexistence in the kingdom, which has become a model for its development and sound reputation among the world nations. Minister of Information Affairs representatives and Shura Council's Affairs Isa Al-Hammadi launched today a comprehensive training program in cooperation with the Journalist Professional Training Center, National Audio Visual Institute and the Royal University for Women, in addition to Temkin and Bahrain Development Bank at the Information Affairs Authority in the attendance of Temkin's chairman and acting chief executive Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al-Khalifa and a number of officials. The minister delivered a speech in which he expressed his content on activating the two MOUs between the Kingdom and France regarding the development of Bahraini press and media caters. The minister stressed the importance of launching such training programs that aim to develop skills and efficiency of media personnel. The World Monuments Fund, the WMF, announced its selection of the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities President Sheikh Hamay bint Mohammed Al Khalifa as the first Arab personality to win the 2015 Watch Award in recognition of the kingdom's cultural achievements and leading role in the preservation of humanitarian and cultural heritage. Sheikh Hamay and Queen Sophia of Spain will be honored today, the 21st, in New York City at the annual Hadrian Gala, which coincides with the World Monuments Fund's 50th anniversary. She said, "This honoring sends a message to the whole world that Arab countries are experiencing sensitive situations whilst their sons do their best to preserve the cultural and historic landmarks," allotting to the Manama-based Regional Arab Center for Global Heritage.